Hello, so currently we have six biomes in the game, and the developers mentioned on their roadmap, and their extended roadmap also hints at something to do with more things coming to these six biomes. And at the end of the year, we'll actually get the first new biome as a new content, which is the Mistlands. We'll actually visit these locations, but first of all, let's make it very, very clear what are the current biomes and what are their states. The first one is the Meadows, the second one is the Black Forest, the third one is the Swamp, fourth is the Mountain, and fifth is of course the Plains. And number six, yeah, you guessed it, is the Ocean. Because the ocean has enemies, has food items, has recipes, has even the weapons. I mean, it's basically a part of a biome, but we'll have another update before the Mistlands update that will add the rest of the content for the ocean. And then number 7 will be the Mistlands, number 8 will be Ashlands, and then it will be number 9, the Deep North. Also, I think we'll have a 10th one, which probably will be the underwater biome. I don't know, but it's just speculating because this is a flat earth. This is the flat earth. If you go to the edge of the map, you can fall down the map. But to be honest, it's actually kind of like a good way to introduce a completely new biome that doesn't mess around with people's servers. So yeah, would be interesting. So why am I saying it? The other biomes might have new updates as well, because the developers mention a lot of stuff, and they also mention mini bosses and special events and more unique locations. And by unique locations, I think they mean let's say special dungeons or special places or bigger places. Now let's go. We have somewhere to be. So let's go first of all to our bigger base, and then we'll go into the Mistlands. To be honest, there is a lot of stuff we don't know about the future updates, because when they made this stuff, I mean the roadmap, I don't think the game was successful. I think they only had sold a few hundred thousand copies or 1 million copies. I'm not sure how much they sold that then, but currently they have sold about 6 million copies, so yeah, the game is definitely successful. So this is for the Ashlands. We'll go on the Ashlands in a bit. I just want to make it very, very clear. This is the flame metal you find in that biome, and this is also the bar. Now sadly, some of the biomes will still be connected to one another, and sometimes you'll feel like some of the enemies will pass through the other, but again, they'll fight each other. Now the Mistlands, as you can see, it's very, very dark, first of all, and it features a lot of spider webs, so we can pretty much guess what the enemies will be over here. I'm not sure about Norse mythology. The cat is on my keyboard. You know what? You have to leave me alone. By the way, the troll is resistant to the ice damage. So that's why I'm not doing as much damage to him. Well, I'm the nutcracker in this. Okay. I was talking about Russian ballet. Now, the fun part is that you have these spider webs which seem almost like they're making a tunnel, so we might have a dungeon nest or a nest dungeon in this place. The Mistlands would probably feature a lot of these. Now I'll increase my gamma because the area is naturally dark. So you'll probably also need kind of like a source of light. By the way, the swordlings are currently in the game and also in this area, the Ashlands. I think they're only placeholder because the swordlings are a tier 3 creature. And this should be a tier 7 or tier 8 biome, actually. As you can see, the Mistlands will have a lot of big trees. I mean, the swamps have the ancient trees, but these ones are even bigger than those. So yeah, probably have spider webs as dungeon, probably will have under the roots dungeon. The further you get into the biome, the Mistlands, the darker it will get. I don't know why, maybe they don't like the light. But that's kind of like everything there is to see right now. If you have seen a picture of the Mistlands biome, that's everything you have to see in the game as well. Not much, except for the shape of the spider web. So that's why I came to this particular forest, because here is the only place that I found the tunnel-like spider webs. Okay, let's take a moment and really appreciate this setting. Also have to let the cat out. So let your imagination go wild with this. And by the way, it looks like the spider webs don't burn. Oh, those little guys, they're so... the little jokers. Okay, now let's go into the Ashlands biome. As you can see, it's definitely a red biome. And it has a lot of... What? You didn't die? It has a lot of ashes floating in the air. I'm not sure this is the final form of the biome, because I think each biome will need to have different ground. Currently it's all stone all over the place, so I might... I don't know, maybe if you dig deep enough you'll have the lava. Or at least some source of coal. Anyway, that's my own opinion. Now I just want to show the flame metal, or it's very hard to pronounce, flame metal. We'll just call it flame metal. Flame metal deposits. I think the sortlings will need to be sorters, which is kind of like a big creature, a very dangerous creature. Or we might even have fire giants at this point, because these creatures will surely not remain here. Maybe only as little annoyances. As you can see, they deal so little damage. Yeah, they might just buff their speed a little bit, make them more dangerous, or make them bigger and tougher. But 10 out of 10 annoying if you don't kill them fast enough. Look at how hard it is to see in this area with all of the smoke. Do I have any stamina potions? No, but I have meat. And I think one of the problems will be the visibility on this map. Okay, enough falling around. Hey, these are all my arrows. So this is how it looks, so let's mine a little bit out of it. Currently it doesn't give you any recipes, even if you smelt it, so I'm not sure what to say about that. Glowing metal, Oh well, let's just leave it over here. Another problem this biome seems to have is that it's made up of a lot of smaller islands, which are not so good, because when the sortlings spawn on islands like these, they actually have nowhere to go, and they sometimes touch the water and die, and if they touch the water, they automatically die. This is another weird mechanic, and I really think they are mostly placeholders for now. Okay, now let's go back the way we came for, and let's see more of this biome. Hey, you can shoot upwards, that's nice. And I don't know, I think the 10th update should be underwater or under the flat world. That would be interesting to see if they can make a world under the flat Earth surface. Okay, let's go back over there because... there's nothing else to see here. I kind of scouted everything, and as you can see, this is just more sortlings with some more glowing metal and sometimes an island like that one. I really hope the game development is much faster than the developers say, because at this rate, everyone will lose interest by the time the new biomes come out, because the first update is only going to be around the house. So new furniture, new stuff to do outside of the house or near the house, and that's about it. Okay, let's go to the deep north. The deep north doesn't actually have any enemies, and yeah, the Mistlands, it's nothing to see, nothing to do. The deep north, nothing to see, nothing to do. Only the Ashland had the Surtlings and also the glowing metal, or the flame metal, that was kind of like a hint at what's going to come. Now, the deep north is actually one of my favorite ones because it features kind of like... Hey, so much snow, look at this. So cool. Oh, okay, this will be a blizzard. We won't be able to see much in this blizzard. It also has this little ice over here. And it's actually physics based, more or less. If you go into one side, you'll tilt it. See? And you'll sink like that. So this might be the new Viking sport. Ice hopping. And you can actually completely drown, completely immerse yourself in the water or fall into the water. And to be honest, when there is a storm, this is even more impressive. Look at this. Sadly, there's nothing to do, and if you try to mine the icebergs, it will give you nothing. As you can see, it's only ice in there. There's nothing to see, nothing to do. Well, you can come here for a nice picnic. Now let's go on to the land a bit, because I want to show you some of that as well. It's a bad time to freeze and a bad time to die. Well, I don't have any healing for me. But you can probably guess how dangerous this will be. And again, there is a problem with the visibility here. I don't like games that kind of introduce mechanics like this. No visibility, nothing like that, no. I just prefer games that give you a clear shot and a clear indication what you're doing. Of course, it's very cool for exploration and that, and we do have the map. But at the same time, if you are being chased by ice giants, this will not be a pleasant experience. Now, I might die here, but that's not important. Before I die, I'll end the video so you don't see me crying over my dead body. To be honest, there are no trees over here. I searched the entire island and I could only find about 3 or 4 trees. That was weird because I don't think we will be able to build much over here except that we make stone houses or stuff like that. Anyway, this is kind of like the whole biome and everything I wanted to show you. See you in the next update. Bye.